Hey Pod Squad, welcome back to the channel. I'm Diksha, a third year podiatric medical student, and today we're going to talk about whether or not podiatric medical school is considered easy to get into or not. So why are we talking about this? Well, we've been seeing a lot of reels and videos that have been getting comments from people that have some misconceptions, so we wanted to address them. Today we're going to have two facts that we're going to bring up that will hopefully show our approach to this. Number one, yes, the stats for applying are definitely lower than what's expected. However, you have to remember that there are a substantial amount of podiatric medical students that are matriculating that have incredible GPAs, stellar MCAT scores, and amazing amount of extracurriculars, right? There are a bunch of those, so we have to keep that in mind. We also have to remember that podiatric medical school has a lot of those students that are cream of the crops, just like any other medical school. It also isn't easy to get through. Why? Well, we have the first 2 years are didactic courses that are taken in medical school. Plus, we also have lower extremity courses on top of that, and we have lower extremity training. Many of our schools are alongside MD and DO students as well. Number two, more and more students are discovering podiatric medicine, and so there's a slow, very gradual rise in applicants. And just as an aside to keep in mind, admissions committees want to make sure that you can handle a rigorous science course load, and also that if there are any setbacks, you're able to bounce back from them. So we have a lot of students that ask us often, hey, are stats good enough? Will we be able to get in with these stats? And we never really have a definitive answer, and we shouldn't be giving a definitive answer, of course, because getting a C in a course won't make or break you, but you have to think about how you handle science courses and reflect on it and be able to understand, okay, can I handle this rigorous course load? And am I able to improve on any of the mistakes I've made in the past? Because that's the most important thing. It might have been hard for you in undergrad, but maybe you learned some tips and tricks since then that you can apply in medical school. As long as you can do that, then that's something to keep in mind. So I hope this helped you understand why this isn't necessarily a yes or no answer. There are multiple factors to consider because every pre-med is unique in their application and in their experiences when they're applying to medical schools. So with that in mind, I hope you enjoyed this video and that it helped you. If you have any questions, make sure just email us or message us on Instagram at thedpmjourney@gmail.com and thepodiatryjourney on Instagram. So also make sure to subscribe if you haven't already and hit that bell notification icon button so that you can keep in touch with us and be alerted and notified whenever we have other videos coming up. So we like to have videos that give tips and tricks about podiatric medical school and for pre-meds. That being said, take care, Pod Squad, signing out.